Hello crafters, I'm JanB and I'm an independent Stampin Up demonstrator. Today I'd like to show you how I made this little teabag holder. It has a ribbon that wraps around the wallet and you just undo the ribbon, as long as you haven't done it up too tight, which it appears what I've done, but it will come open. And then inside there's the little wallet part with the tea bag in. You could also use this if you wanted to give somebody some money or a gift card or any kind of little thing that comes as a sachet like that. It was inspired by a swap I received when I went to the Stampin Up OnStage Live Convention in Amsterdam at the beginning of April. When I got back home, I shared all my swaps on a video and one of my YouTube subscribers asked me if I could show how this one was made. It was made by Jacqueline Florance, who goes by the name of Florence of Arabia. She didn't stick this on here. I took this off the bag that it was in, which is why it's looking a bit tatty, because I didn't want to lose contact details of the person who'd made it. So this is where I got the idea from. Many thanks for this, Jacqueline. It's a great idea. Absolutely love it. So I'm going to start off by telling you the card pieces we're going to need. I'm using this design, which is from Succulent Gardens, and this measures 4 inches by 9¾ inches, which is 10.1 by 24 centimetres. You need two pieces of, I recommend that you use Whisper White. I'm actually using Shimmery White cardstock. The only reason I'm doing this is because I had so much left over from my daughter's wedding invitations. I'm trying to use up the scraps, but if I didn't have these, I would certainly be using Whisper White. And all three pieces, and this is Sweet Sugarplum, which is this one here that I've picked out. They all measure approximately 2 inches by 3 inches, which is about 7.5 by 5 centimetres. Yep, that's right. So the first thing we need to do is to score this. So if you have the pattern facing up that you want on the outside, and then you need to score at 3¼ inches and 6½ inches. When you score on paper, make sure that you use the largest end to your embossing tool. Okay, don't use a thin one because it is paper and it would be very easy to go straight through. So 3¼ inches and 6½ inches, which is 8 centimetres and 16 centimetres. And equally, don't press too hard. So that's all the scoring we need to do. This is an amazingly easy project to do. I don't know how many Florence made, but it would have taken quite a lot of patience to do this, I think. So if you fold on your two score lines, and make sure that as you're folding, your cardstock is, your paper is lining up properly. And then what we need to do, this is going to be the inside of mine, so we need to cut off this corner here. So if you take a pair of, if you take a ruler rather, and you want to put a pencil mark here, which is just on the right hand side of your fold mark there. Yes, it has left a mark. And then you want to bring it down to this corner here. So that's that mark there. Swivel it around to here. Make sure I haven't moved. That's about right. So draw, oh, that's right. It's the way the light is shining on this. It's making it that I really can't see it, but I can when I tilt it. Don't know if that, oh, you can see that one, can you? Yes, you can see that. Right, so what we need to do is to cut that off. If you want to use your trimmer, obviously you can. For me, it's a straight line, and a large pair of scissors would do the job. Okay, so that's going to be coming down like that. Where's my tea bag? I'll show you which colour I'm using for this. This is the colour that I'm going to be using for my tea bag. So what I'm going to do is I need to glue this, and I'm going to use my fast fuse because that is really nice and strong. So I'm working on my silicone craft mat so that I don't get glue on my work paper. There we go. And then just adhere that over, but make sure that that lines up nice and straight. Okay, don't worry if you get a little bit of a bulge there. That's okay, because you're going to put something in there. And then what you need to do is, with your corner rounder, now this is going to retire, so if you want to buy one of these, you need to get in quickly. Otherwise, use whatever corner rounder you have. There we go. And then when you put your paper into your corner rounder, make sure that this side here and this side here fit nicely against these wings. If you haven't got it in there straight, or you haven't folded straight, it's not going to punch correctly. Okay, make sure it's straight, punch. Make sure it's in there straight, punch. And make sure it's in there straight and punch. Now what you will find is that you'll get a little bit of a funny cut there. It depends on where you've actually done your diagonal cut, how big that is going to be, but it really doesn't matter. It's not going to affect what you're doing. So the next thing we need to do is to put our ribbon on, and the only sweet sugar plum ribbon I have at the moment is this one, which was in our spring catalogue. It will be retiring at the end of March, end of May rather. So if you want any of this, again, it's something that you need to move quite quickly on. Right, now what I'm doing with my silicone mat here, I'm putting it in the centre. You can't see me down here, can you? I'm putting it in the centre here. So that's 3 inches and that's 3 inches. You don't have to be exactly precise about this. It's just as a guideline. I have 16 inches of ribbon here. Folded it in half. And where I've got my half mark there, I'm going to put that on that thick dark line that I can see coming through there. I'm just going to lay that out straight. Now, this one you can use snail on, and from that halfway mark you need to just put some snail on about 2 inches. Maybe I will use Oh, that's better. Try using it the right way. Let's try that again. There we go. Okay, so that's not coming out. I do wonder if it's because... Oh, there we go. That got it. Okay. I'm going to do it a little bit further. Okay, so I've actually gone from there to there, which is going to be fine. Now I've got to do the same on this side. That hasn't gripped at all. I think this is because my ribbon is too fluffy. The other ribbons haven't given me this trouble at all. I'll show you which other ribbons I've been using. That's it. There's enough on there. That'll hold. if you have trouble like that, you may want to try using fast fuse. So what you do now is you bring your wallet back and you're going to line this edge, the folded edge, you're going to line it up against this dark line down here. Make sure your ribbon is straight and then place this about halfway. Again, this isn't going to be crucial. Okay, so give that a chance to adhere to the ribbon underneath. And then with this ribbon, pull this over and it's just got to line up with the ribbon on the opposite side. Okay, we're going to be adhering something over the top here, so that's going to hold it in place. It's not going to go walkabouts anywhere. So the next thing that we need to do is do some stamping and some die cutting. The stamp that I've used is from Bunch of Blossoms. Today is a perfect day to be happy. I think any day is a perfect day to be happy, but there we go, that's a nice saying. And I'm going to be using Sweet Sugarplum ink. I'm going to be die cutting this with an oval, so I'm just going to pop this right in the centre. Lovely. This is a beautiful stamp, it really is. Now what I need to do is to die cut the oval and the two layering ovals. So I'll lift my Big Shot up. Let's see, that about right. And the dies that I'm going to be using are from the layering oval frames. I'm using the that's number 5 straight cut die. Oh, you can't see that. That's number 5 straight cut die. Okay, so that should be in that one. And the scallop is the number 4 die, and this one is the second size in the stitched shaped frame nets. I recently made a video showing how I actually store my dies, what the who I buy the folder from, how I do this, and I don't normally do that on the back, and do this bit. And also at the end of the video I explained how I number my dies. So if you want to check that out, it's video number 273. And if you only want to know about the numbering of the dies, if you just skip to the last 2 minutes, it's only a 10 minute video, so it doesn't take too long to watch. Right, so I'm lining the sentiment up with the stitched shape die, and then the scalloped die is going to cut one of the white, no it's not, it's going to cut the pink one, and then the white one is going to be cut with the straight die. So that's going to, this one's going to layer onto that, which is going to layer onto that. I just absolutely love these stitched dies. So there we have the straight cut oval, and here we have the scalloped cut oval. This little teabag holder is what I'm making for all my customers, my online customers who've shopped during April with me. I always send thank you presents to my customers. If you don't have a Stampin Up demo, I'll put the link to my shop in the box below. Right, so I've put some Tombow on that. Upside down, but it doesn't matter. Pop that in the centre of the scallop. And then I'm going to put some Tombow on the back of this one. And this is a much tighter fit. There we go. Oops, doesn't look very straight, does it? That looks better. Right, so now what I'm going to do is I am going to adhere that down on top like that. You could decide that you want to pop that up on dimensionals because you might not like the idea it's going over. I mean, this one's quite a thick ribbon. You might not like the idea of that bump. But the reason I'm going to adhere mine down totally is to make sure that the ribbon stays in place. But it is a choice that you have. Right, okay. So I'm just going to pop that on top. Make sure that stays straight. Make sure that's going on straight. Just give it a few seconds to get a grip. Normally I would just put this on one side and leave it for 2-3 minutes. But as this is a video, I'm going to do it straight away. Do it up straight away. Okay, so the tea bag pops in there. And then I find it best if I do the ribbon up so the knot on the ribbon is at the front here. Let's see if it works with this thick ribbon as well. Okay, so just tie the knot there. Normal bow. Well, I think that has got to go. Oh, maybe if you want to go sideways, all right. I was going to say that's got to be one of the lousiest bows I've ever done. But it looks that it wants to go sideways, which is okay by me. I don't mind. In fact, that bit needs to turn over. Sometimes if you just pull these side to side like a saw, you can get them to turn over. There we go. Not really very well, but I will play with that off screen and tidy that up. When I post this to my blog, you'll see whether I was successful with it or not. So I'm just going to tidy the end up. And tidy that end up. I'm not going to cut it any shorter because I've got to tie it again. But there we go, that's the project. I'm not going to try and tie that one up. Let me just show you some others that I made. I made this one, which is using the Carried Away. Was it called Carried Away? Let me see. I can't see the name now. Yes, I can. Carried Away. It was one of the design series papers that was on offer during Sale-a-bration. Rather than having to keep doing these up. I'm just going to show you. And this was the first one that I did practicing with this design, and I used the designer series paper stack. This was Daffodil Delight, and the ribbon that I've used there is a Stampin Up one, but it retired a long time ago, but it went really nicely with the project. And then these two, what we were doing in class last weekend, I was using the Beautiful You stamp set, and we had three projects, two cards, and this was our 3D project. And I was demonstrating three different ways of colouring the ladies. So that one was water colouring, that one was paper piecing, and there was another one where we used the stamp that comes with the set. But I also wanted to show you this one, because I experimented with this one doing it with cardstock rather than doing it with designer series paper. Obviously that's a lot thicker. And then I cut that to size and adhered them on. It looks really nice. I don't think it's really necessary. Definitely a matter of choice whether that's what you want to do or not. But it's a lovely project. I think the DSP is more than enough, which I don't normally, I have to say. But I was really pleased with that. I hope you do too. I hope you like it too. And in fact, let's leave that one there. And I hope you decide to give it a try. Many thanks for joining me today. If you have any questions, please... Oh dear, it's my mobile. If you have any questions, please leave a comment in the box below or email me at janb@janbcards.com. I will put that in the box below just in case that the phone was louder than me. If you would like to purchase any of the products that I featured here today, not these precise ribbons because they are all retired now. I think that one you may still be able to get, but the others are retired. But there are other suitable ribbons available for these colours, and where possible I'll put them on the screen for you. If you've enjoyed my video and you'd like to know each time I upload another one, please subscribe to my YouTube channel. And finally, I will put all the products I've used and the measurements on the screen, and I will also put them in the box below. If you click on the arrow below the video, that will open up a big box, and I'll put all the products, my email address, the link to my shop and everything down there, so it's all nice and convenient for you. Many thanks for joining me today. Until next time, happy crafting. Cheerio.